Hey everyone, it is Josh here with HostGator. Today we are excited to show you how to build a new WordPress website from the ground up. In this series, we'll help you take your website from looking like this to looking like this in just a few easy steps. We're going to be checking out the menus and widget sections today because they are key to your site's navigation. I think we all know what makes menus important, as they're what allow visitors to navigate your site easily. Widgets, however, are a little bit less known, but no less important. As always, we'd love to hear what you think about the content that we're making, so feel free to give us some notes in the comments below and subscribe if you want to see more. If you haven't watched the previous episodes, I would definitely recommend getting caught up. I put a link to the playlist in the description below so you can get caught up really easily, but if not, then let's get started. Before we get started with our edits today, I want to show you what the website looks like now. So let's click over to joshmakestutorials.com and take a look at our homepage. Now, we've made a lot of progress so far, but we haven't really done any work on the homepage. If you remember our last episode, we made a new about page. Now, let's click over to that too. As you can see up top, I see my homepage, my blog, and my contact, but I actually don't see the About Us page that I made. Today, we're going to get our default menu updated, and I'll show you how to go about creating a new menu in case you need to do a couple of different ones for your site. So to kick things off today, let's head back to our WordPress dashboard. Today, we're going to navigate to the Menu section, which is actually under the Appearance tab. So we'll hover over Appearance and then click on Menus. So here we are in the menu section of our WordPress dashboard. Now, before we get started, it's important to note that you can do a lot of these functions inside the Customize section of your theme, but today I want to show you how to do this directly on the menu page. The first thing to note here is the menu structure. As you can see, we've got our Home, Blog, and Contact page that references directly what we just saw on the home page of my site. Over here on the left-hand side, you can see we have the option to add new menu items to that menu. What I want to do today is add my About page that I just created to my menu structure. So I'm going to click on About, and I'm going to click Add to Menu. As you can see, it appeared here. So now I've got Home, Blog, Contact, and About, but I really want the About to be the second option. So I'm going to click and drag this to be the second option. The next thing that we want to talk about is the menu settings. As I can see here, I've got a desktop horizontal menu selected. I can have an expanded menu selected if I want to, but I like the horizontal section. You can also have a mobile menu and a footer menu and a social menu if you like. Now currently the 2020 theme has a social links menu, which is a little further down the page, but I also want to add my menu to the footer. So I'm going to click here. And once that's done, I'm going to save all of my changes. Now that my changes are saved, let's go and take a look at what the site looks like. I'm going to head back to my site, do a hard refresh. And as you can see here, now my About page is up here in my top level menu. Very easy to click to, take me right to that page. We'll head back to the WordPress dashboard now and I'll show you how to make a new one. Now that we're back in the menu section, let's learn how to create a new one. Right up here in the middle, I'll click create a new menu. Now since I already have a primary menu, I'm going to name this one Test Menu 1. You can choose the menu settings down here, and as soon as you're ready to create, just click create. Now that the menu is created, you can see here that it's appeared in the Select a Menu to Edit section. Since I'm using my primary, I'm going to head back to that one. Before we move on to the next section, I do want to show you one of the cooler options in the Add Menu Items page. Earlier, we added my About page to my main top level menu, but let's say that I have a cool blog post or I want to link to an external site, I can do that down here as well. Say I've got a really awesome blog post, I can select that here and then add it to my menu. Or if I want to link to someone else's site and I have that URL, I can enter the URL here and then easily add that to the menu as well. Now that we've got that taken care of, let's head over to our widget section. On the left-hand side, let's choose widgets underneath the appearance tab, and we'll click there. Welcome to the widget section of your dashboard. Widgets are one of my favorite parts of WordPress because they play a huge role in customizing your theme. These are essentially features that are built into your theme that you can toggle on and off. And some of the common ones that you'll see are calendars, different image galleries, metadata, RSS feeds, search functions, and a whole lot more. You can see here with our theme 2020 that I've got two that are already built into my footer, number one and number two. Now it's really important to note that themes will have different display options such as in a sidebar or in a header, so make sure to take your website's needs into account when you're choosing your theme. For our case, let's say I want to add a blog calendar to the bottom of our site. All I have to do is essentially go over here to the calendar section and then choose which footer widget I want to put it into. Now let's say I want to add it to the footer number one, essentially click here and then click add widget. Now I can see that I've got some text about this site and then I've got my calendar in footer number one. Now I'm going to use some of the widgets that are already in my footer to build out some content for my site, and I'll be right back when I'm done to show you exactly what I did. All right, I'm back from making those changes, so now let me show you what I did. We'll start off in footer number one. That one had an existing text widget. All I did was essentially change the title and add some information about myself and why we started this project. And a few minutes ago, you saw when we added the calendar widget as well. So that's gonna show up on footer number one, which is essentially on the left side of my bottom page. Moving over to footer number two, it has the same text widget inside of there as well. I just made some changes in here to show off HostGator's address, 24/7 support, our phone number, our chat system, and then I went to Google Maps and I found the embed link directly for our location map, and I pasted that inside of the box as well. Now that it's saved, let's go over to our page and see what it looked like before and then after we made these changes. I'll scroll all the way down to the bottom. As you can see, I've got my old information here for my widgets. Let's do a hard refresh and see what it looks like now. And this looks great. I've got my text snippets here. I've got my calendar at the bottom on the left-hand side, my Find Us information, and also my Google image link right here as well. I think this looks great. Let's head back to the widget section. We'll talk a little bit more about them. Before we move on to the next topic, I definitely want to encourage you to take all the time that you need to explore the widget options that you want for your site and pick a theme that has those options available. As you can see, 2020 only has options for footer number one and number two. So if you need a sidebar or a header or something different, you can choose a theme that has those options available to you directly. And that just about covers your menus and widgets page. Thanks so much for watching. If you found this series helpful so far, leave us a comment below and subscribe if you want to see more. Thanks, y'all.